Hi everybody, here's Krystian from TeamworkCast.
And this is Nick, the cringeworthy member of the Cringecast.
Mm-hmm. And welcome to Netrunning with Cringecast.
Yay!
Netrunning with TeamworkCast. We are here at Highlander Games in Dortmund, and they organized a Chronos Protocol Tournament, which is a special kind of tournament only available in Europe, with some excellent cards, and you can vote for cards that get printed in the future. It was so good. So good.
You're
so
on
many
the left
prizes.
Now.
I'm on the left now. We changed things. It still looks like a potato because the lighting wasn't so great and my camera is just not so good. And
is this a Lord of the Rings?
Yeah.
Play that?
Not sure. Oh no, it's a Warhammer 40K.
I didn't know there was a
Wait a minute.
Warhammer.
No. The shields are Warhammer 40K. Not sure what the thing is from. Anyway, I am playing Andromeda, which we saw previously already. She starts with 9 cards, and my opponent is playing Jinteki.
That is a Warhammer Fantasy living card game.
Maybe. That's very...
It is.
My opponent is playing Jinteki. Jinteki Personal Evolution. He does 1 net damage every time he or me scores an agenda. So lots of net damage going on around. And my opponent is Julian. No, wait, it's not Julian. What am I talking about? It's Fabian.
Fabian.
And the other Ian. But yes, very, very polite, very nice dude. And he's playing Jinteki. So he gets like, you know, heart points. Right there. Sympathy points. Because Jinteki is awesome. And especially now that a new expansion came out with Jinteki, lots of new Jinteki cards. The Jinteki should get even better. But of course, we are playing this before this expansion came out. So he's still playing with old cards. And he's going to try to kill me with net damage. And let's see if this works. Ah, yes. So we are contemplating our hands. For me as Andromeda, it's of course very important to have the right hand. And he starts. He puts an ice in front of his HQ. And... and nothing. So, Nick, you like Jinteki a lot, right?
I do. I think that the Jinteki are a fun corporation that has... bad reputation.
No, that's Wayland.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, you mean bad reputation, bad publicity. Ah, never mind. So Jinteki does the thing that Jinteki does, which is he's playing this shell game kind of game where he installs a lot of servers, non-protected, and you kind of have to guess what it is.
Yeah.
So it's my turn, my mega turn. We have to play 4 cards, otherwise I will lose. Well, I will lose my advantage. I'm playing a short gamble, which gets me 4 credits.
I really like the Harmony MedTech.
I don't
identity. They are.
That's a new one, I think.
Each player needs 1 fewer agenda points.
Yeah, that's a new one that just came out. It wasn't available at this point. I'm playing a. Dirty Laundry run on one of the cards that he installed, and it turned out to be a Jackson Howard, and I decided to trash it, because why would I allow a Jackson Howard to roam the plains of the Planeswalkers? Wait a minute, different game.
Oh, no.
Yes. We're kind of like crossing the games a little bit. Warhammer action going on the right. I'm going Planeswalkers. Yes, and I'm installing... Army Touch Code Busting, a card that will give me money when I click it. It gives me 2 money for every click I spend on it. But after 12 monies, it's over. And then I install a Desperado Console. Now, that was not very smart of me, and I'm making this mistake all the time. I think there will be more games where I make the same mistake. But I should have installed the Desperado before I made the run.
Yeah.
Ugh. But you know, you see the events and you want to play the events very quickly, and then you think, oh, and then I'm going to do something else later on. Well. Alright, so he installs a card and advises it twice, and it turns out to be a Clone Retirement. And he does now 1 net damage to me, because he scored an agenda. Ah, yes. There goes a special order. I have to apologize for the glare on the cards. Yeah. Happens a lot. I don't have any polarization filter for my GoPro. But, you know, we always show the cards later on when I play them. Also, it's he does this thing where he creates little piles of money on his card. And it's, for us camera viewers, it can be difficult to see how many credits there are. I access this other card and it's a Project June bug, but it's not advanced, so it's not not a dangerous thing. If it was advanced, he would be able to do net damage to me, but it's not advanced. Alright, so I'm accessing his... I'm going for his hand.
Uh-oh.
What is on his hand? It's a clone retirement. I score it. And the problem with Jinteki, every time you score something like, oh yeah, oh wait a minute, I get net damage. Ugh. And he is able to snipe a clone chip from my hand, which is very bad because if I lose something due to net damage, I can't get it back. The clone chip would allow me to get things back that have been trashed. But now the clone chip itself is trashed. No. Yes, but you know, with Jinteki, you kind of have to embrace the net damage because it will happen.
It's like Dark Souls. You don't get attached to your souls because you're going to lose them anyway.
That's true. That's the same thing. So I'm getting a money, I guess. Wait a minute. Did I really get a money? Oh, I got the money for the run. And then I'm playing Corroder. So the thought process here is I don't need a Corroder right now, but before it gets trashed due to net damage, I'd rather play it.
You gotta be careful. You gotta have some cards in your hand.
Yeah, yeah. So hopefully I will draw some cards now. I'm thinking of making a run on R&D, but I'm afraid it might be a fetal AI. And so I'm contemplating this, and I'm even saying this to my opponent, to Fabian. Like, I'd rather not make a run on R&D. I'd rather draw a card. It might be a fetal AI. And he draws a card, and it is actually fetal AI. So I could have lost the game just there, but I was sober enough to realize that this might be very dangerous with this deck, and it paid off. All right, so he draws in yet another card. And he installs ice in front of his R&D. The thing is with Jinteki is like, you kind of want to have the runner access your cards because there are so many traps and things in your deck. It's kind of like difficult to judge, you know, how to ice up your stuff. So, small confusion, I'm making a run on his hand. And what is it? I already got the credit for it. And it is the fetal AI he just drew. But now I have enough cards to suffer all the damage I get from this. So the fetal AI is one of those agendas that's difficult to score because I have to pay money for it. And then I need to take net damage for it, and then I get the net damage because I score an agenda because of his identity. So it's like, so much punishment.
Because you have to steal a baby. You're stealing Wizard and Andromeda's baby.
Maybe it could be. I always think that the Fetal AI is also like it's something like a baby dragon, you know?
Yeah.
You want to liberate it, but it doesn't understand, so it just, you know, spits fire on whoever touches it. And you're like, stop spitting fire on me, I'm liberating you. So that's what the fetal AI is. It tries to kill me with its brain while I'm hacking it free. And it also looks creepy as hell. I mean, it has this little baby fetus with an exposed brain and glowing eyes. Ugh. All right, it's my turn. He did something. I guess he got money and cards. I was too busy talking about the fetal AI. It just got me too excited.
That's okay. I'm excited too.
Yes. So I'm installing a mimic, which lets me break sentries, which is good. because sentries make damage, and there is going to be a lot of damage from Jinteki. And then I am clicking for money from Armitage Code Busting.
Busting some code.
Armitage Code. Last
uh-oh.
Click.
Uh-oh, thinking about going.
Yeah, you're always tempted. You're always tempted, but that's how Jinteki gets you. And I'm doing the run. Last click. Access. I see. I think it's a swordsman I see. I'm not exactly sure. But nothing of importance to me right now. Oh no, that wasn't the final click. That was the last click, I guess. The second to last click. And I'm getting a card. And I'm getting a credit for the run. Because of Desperado. And he's playing a giraffe.
Ah, giraffes.
It is a celebrity gift, which is a little baby giraffe. And he shows me cards on his hand. And for each card that he shows me, he gets lots of money. Do you think that giraffe would be a good thing to have in your purse?
Well, I think that if they can construct a tiny giraffe, that everybody would want one.
Yeah.
Especially if it could be programmed to do tricks.
Hmm. Or like maybe it's like a genetically modified giraffe. Like a
yeah.
That would be so great. I mean, look at it. It looks so cute on this card.
It's a teacup giraffe, is what they call it.
Uh-huh.
Miranda Rhapsody had one in it, and now everyone wants one.
Do you think Miranda Rhapsody is kind of like Miley Cyrus of this world?
Possibly.
Do you
I think her more as Victoria Beckham.
Or what if she's like, what was the blonde non-celebrity of this rich...
Oh, Paris Hilton?
Yeah. I think it
quite
might
possibly,
but Rhapsody is quite a good name, I think. Yes. All right. So I play a sure gamble.
I'm getting us off track a lot. To say.
we're so focused on this giraffes, we don't even notice what Jinteki is doing. But there is the board is not developing, so I guess he just gets money and he gets cards.
He gets money and he calls it a day.
Not exactly sure why he has a counter, bad publicity counter on his thing. I don't think he has bad publicity. Oh, he does have bad publicity because I scored Clone Retirement and that gets bad publicity. So again, he plays yet another giraffe.
Yet another so celebrity many. Gift.
And yeah, that's good for him because, you know, as a Jinteki, you're kind of struggling with money. So a rich Jinteki is a mighty Jinteki indeed. And also, he spoils a little bit that he has a shock on his hand. No, wait a minute, he's a snare. It's a snare. So I know that running on his hand I might run into a snare, and would that give me a lot of net damage and a tag as well? So that would be very, very bad.
Oh, 3 net damage. That would kill you right now, wouldn't it?
I don't know. I think my hand is full. I have the habit of like putting all of my hand cards together. Yeah, I have a full
hand. Oh, yeah, you have a full hand.
Yeah, I wouldn't run against Jinteki with anything less than a full hand.
Your opponent's doing a thing that drives me crazy.
Oh, he's also wiggling with his foot?
No, he's playing with cards upside down in his hand.
Mm.
Oh, my
no.
God.
That's brutal. That's mind games with you, Nick.
I know.
I played a... what is it called again? Oh, Katie Jones. Our favorite, Katie Jones.
Lady about town.
Katie Jones. Lady who sees places. So I... Oh, yeah, we see a Tsurugi there. Tsurugi is a sentry. It has end the run, and corporation can decide if it's end the run. They can pay 1 credit, and if they pay 1 credit, then instead of end the run, it continues into 3 subroutines, which are both do 1 net damage, or something like this. Let me see. I haven't seen this card too often, but it's very cool because the corp can decide what it does. Yes, it does 3 net damage afterwards. So the corporation can decide what this card does, if it does end the run, or if it does 3 net damage. And as a runner, you kind of still want to have to break all 3 subroutines to make sure, or 4 subroutines to make sure none of this happens. So I'm trashing Cerebral Override. Oh yes, good, I think I found this. And there was a Hokusai grid, which I also trashed. And I'm using Katie Jones. I'm uploading Katie Jones.
Help me, Katie Jones!
Katie, catch this click. See you later. So Jinteki, at this point, I don't know. The board doesn't develop very well. I think he didn't draw as much eyes as he wanted. I'm not really sure what his game plan is, if he really just wants to kill me with net damage.
Yeah.
I mean, we've seen a lot of traps so far. So this may be just his strategy, like this death of a thousand cuts, as they say. He's counting his cards. Maybe another giraffe coming up? No, he has a discard. And he just gets money. Lots of money. There's something that requires a lot of money.
Needs a lot of
money. Oh no,
money.
He didn't discard. He played a hedge fund. That's why I don't like people playing cards directly into archives.
Yeah.
Because you cannot discern this from playing a card and discarding a card. But then he plays a card into creating an invisible server. A server where nothing is inside. And then it's my turn again. What will happen? So Nick, is this the way you like Jinteki?
You know, I am amazed at how much money this guy has.
Mm-hmm.
He's opening my eyes.
Celebrity Gift was a recent card that came out, and it was a card that Jinteki really needed because they had some really big...
money problems.
Money problems, indeed. So I'm getting on R&D again. I'm spending a lot of money to get through Tsurugi. And I see nothing of importance. Another ice. I can hear you clicking, Nick. I can hear you clicking. You know, you have only 4 clicks per round.
It's true. And they go by so quickly.
Yes. So my opponent, Fabian, installs an ice in front of R&D because I have been running on R&D quite successfully. And it makes sense to tighten up the security there. But Tsurugi cost me a lot of money and I don't think I would be able to get through it again. So...
Uh-oh.
I don't think it's really necessary. Uh-oh, there is a card being installed.
Uh-oh.
Into the server, and that's the problem with Jinteki. You just don't know what it is. Is it a trap? Is it an agenda? Just no way to find out. For me, at least. If I had infiltration, that would be no problem, but I don't play infiltration. And then he installs another ice. Anything could be in that server. On the other hand, I've seen that there were no agendas on his hand through all those giraffes. And I've been running on his R&D pretty heavily, so I know that it's unlikely that there will be an agenda there.
Yeah, and you know that he has a snare in his hand.
Yeah, so this could be a snare. I'm getting the Kitty Jones money. With the first click. Second click, I'm installing Crypsis. Crypsis is not the icebreaker I need right now, but it kind of completes my suite. So I can break everything now with Crypsis. I'm using Crypsis basically as my code gate breaker. I'm putting a counter on Crypsis. He is not quite as familiar with Crypsis, so I've refreshed him. Explaining how the counters work. Every time I use Crypsis, one of the counters gets removed. If there's no counters on Crypsis and I still keep using Crypsis, the Crypsis gets trashed. So I kind of have to charge up Crypsis before I use it. And I decide to do nothing else on this turn, Nick. Nick is clicking still.
Clicking still.
Just clicking.
So I'm looking through cards for the Jinteki.
You are building a deck while we speak.
Yes.
You should get the new expansion. It has so many cool Jinteki cards.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. There's a lot that are new that are in here.
Hmm. You can do like mind games. He installs yet another ice in front of R&D. R&D really secure at this point. He really needs to remove this R&D lock I have been building up for a couple of turns, where I control every card he draws. I'm looking at every card that he will draw, so I make sure he gets no agendas. He kind of wants to get some agendas out, or maybe some traps, because I can also trash the traps. I trashed the Cerebral Overwriter, so he couldn't use it against me. Now there are two cards in the server.
This is the sort of power that the Jinteki have. It's kind of amazing.
Yeah, and then you think like, oh, it's a trap, I'm not going to run it. And then, you know, at the end
of
the game...
You run on it, and it's a trap, and you're like, oh,
or you don't run on it, and then at the end of the game, oh, by the way, this was an agenda all along. Psych!
Although it looks like he's starting to get a little low. Oh, no, he's still got 16.
Yeah, he's fine. He has, the money is not an issue for him. Money is an issue for me a little bit. I'm getting some money from Army Touch, I guess. And I'm running this new card. He considers to rez or not to rez.
Or he might just be playing a mind game with you. Trying to get your hopes up before he damages your brain.
Or he thinks if... You know, sometimes you want to rez something, even if it's a trap.
Yeah.
To make me pay to get inside the server, and then it's a trap.
Pay for your own brain surgery.
Yeah. But it is, in fact, an agenda. It is a veterans program. It's 1 point. He's doing 1 net damage.
Are you at 5 now?
I think I'm at 4.
4? Okay.
And he's at 1. Not very big agendas he has in there. Makes sense, because every time somebody scores an agenda, 1 net damage is done.
I like your little box.
It is very useful. He also has a box. What's in the box?
It looks like you're not using the standard tackle boxes. Is that actually meant for what it's being used for?
I don't know. What's a tackle box?
Tackle box is a thing you bring with you to go, like, fishing or...
It is a tackle box, yes.
Oh, okay.
It is, like, for screws or for little things.
All
right, so he rezzes... we see the other card that was in there. That's Jackson Howard.
Jackson Howard.
The good Paul Jackson Howard. So he can now draw cards like a madman. And he does just that.
What if Jackson Howard and Katie Jones had a show together?
That would be so great. Gosh. My two
or maybe they could just star in a, like...
Huh?
And their own little separate card game.
Hmm. That would be also nice. Yeah, you know, there are other games in the Netrunner universe. In the Android universe.
I have not played any of them.
I played the one I think they called Infiltration.
Oh, okay.
And it's really good.
Oh, that's cool. But Fantasy Flight's been doing solid work for years now.
Yeah, they're really good, those guys. They're really good. And, you know, Netrunner is just... It's the best. It's so good. Mm. So he ices up in server right there. So look at him. He's developing his board quite rapidly in the recent rounds. There has been nothing going on for a lot of rounds. Now suddenly this explosion of ice.
Raining ice.
It's raining ice. It's a blizzard of ice. I guess Jackson Howard's really brought like a second winter to this thing.
He's the Ned Stark of Netrunner.
To continue this analogy, yes, he raises up the ice wall. And I'm still Jon Snow, I don't know nothing. Alright, I'm using up Armitage Code Busting. It has been hanging around for long enough. It has paid off quite well. And with I'm charging up Katie Jones. Oh, I'm looking for this number. Ugh! And I'm getting yet another counter on Crypsis, because Crypsis will be used, perhaps. I don't want to be running in one of those servers and realize there are two code gates suddenly there, you know?
Yeah.
Oh yes, my opponent has been able to draw some cards recently, so I'm assuming he has some agendas on there that he tries to score right now. Of course, against a full breaker suite and quite a lot of money, and even some money on Katie Jones, you kind of have to assume that I will be able to get in anything he gets out. On the other hand, he is Jinteki, so he can just as easily put a trap in there. And that may be a trap, or it may be an agenda. He puts it into the secure server. Do you think it's a trap, Nick?
I think there's a 50% chance it is a trap.
Well, and then there's a second card in the less secure server.
All traps.
All traps?
Yep. Now, he's only got four agendas in his deck, and all four of them are on the table.
That would be an illegal deck, and it's actually something that... Something that happened in the game. People were checking the tournament organizers were checking the decks, and they found a mistake in one of the decks, which was an honest mistake. Like the guy just mixed up two cards. They had very similar art, and he actually wanted the other cards, and he absentmindedly put the wrong card in there, and they had to disqualify him.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Yeah, very unfortunate. Let him put it in.
So I'm making Maker's Eye run on R&D, which allows me to see two more additional cards, which is really great. There's a lot of ice in there, so he's thinking about what to res and what not to res. Also, keep in mind that I'm completely ignoring the cards that he installed there, thinking that it might be a trap. So the first ice I encounter is a Wall of Thorns. It's a 5 strength barrier. It does 2 net damage and it ends the run. I'm using Corroda and a lot of money to get through it. Continuing on, I encounter a Chum, which is a 4 strength code gate. And the next ice, the strength of the next ice is increased.
He had those in the wrong order.
And it does 3 more damage if the next ice is not broken. So I'm not exactly sure how I solve this. So I think I'm going to use Crypsis to break this.
Yeah.
To break the chump. So the strength of the next ice is not increased. And I don't get the 3 damage. But I will break the next ice anyway. So I spent all my money, almost all my money, and I get to access the cards. So the first one is nothing important. This one I score. It is a 1 point Gila hands, and what is it?
Get you?
Brain trust. It's a brain trust. I can score this. I'm doing, it does 2 damage because I scored 2 agendas there. But it doesn't matter because I win the game. It's enough points.
Oh, man.
I won another game.
You're getting amazing. Oh, my God.
I'm getting powerful.
Power.
Yes, there's a second game in this round, but we haven't recorded this because it ended prematurely. No, it didn't end prematurely. It ended, we ran out of time, and my opponent actually won this. So this was actually a good round for both of us.
Yeah, that is a good run.
It was a timed win, so not as effective as a normal win, but it was still a win. So yes, very, very excellent game against Fabian, and I'm really respecting him for using Jinteki there. A really exciting always run against Jinteki because, you know, you're on the edge of your seat because everything you do will result in net damage. You're trashing so many cards, you're just running through your deck, and you're like, I hope I don't lose any important cards. And you are a big fan of Jinteki yourself, right?
Actually, my wife is more of a fan of Jinteki than I am. I just played against Jinteki a lot because... she likes hurting me, I guess. I don't know what that says about our relationship.
Yeah. If you like hurting people, then Jinteki is certainly the identity, the corporation type, corporation fraction for you. All right, so we will be back next episode where this will be then the fourth round of this tournament. Yes, it's the fourth round of this tournament.
Fourth round.
So join us on our next episode. Until then, hack the planet!
Shut up and get in the car!
Shit on me.
Yes, that was nice.